So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another class of PIB 247. In today's session, we are going to talk about the PIB news from 26th and 27th of December 2022. And yes, this would be the last class of 2022. And agli baar jab hum milenge, wo 2023 hoga. I hope you guys have learned something from the from one last year, 2022. Aur jo bhi aapne galtiyan ki hain, I hope 2023 mein aap usko sudharenge. रेजोल्यूशन के बारे में अगर बात करें तो रेजोल्यूशन सिंपली आपका यही होना चाहिए कि जो आपने नहीं सीख पाए 2022 में वो आप 2023 में सीखेंगे, या जो गलतियां आपने 2022 में करी हैं वो 2023 में रिपीट नहीं होंगी. ऑलराइट, इतना ही अगर आप कर लेते हैं तो इतना काफी होगा आप लोगों के लिए. इनफैक्ट हम सबके लिए इतना काफी है. ओके, सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ टुडे. 15 startups were recently selected in first of its kind Nirman Accelerator program. It is supported by DST, which is Department of Science and Technology, through its Nidhi scheme portfolio. Which institute had launched this program in 2022? So remember, Nirman Accelerator program is not a, you know, abhi launch nahi hua hai. Yes, it was launched this year only, but abhi ye launch nahi hua hai. It is in news currently because 15 startups have been selected under this program to provide support. All right, so अब क्योंकि ये न्यूज में आया है तो इट इज आवर ड्यूटी टू डिस्कस. राइट, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस निर्माण एक्सेलरेटर प्रोग्राम. तो व्हाई इट इज इन न्यूज, मैंने आपको बता दिया ऑलरेडी, बिकॉज 15 स्टार्टअप्स हैव बीन सिलेक्टेड अंडर दिस प्रोग्राम टू प्रोवाइड सपोर्ट. एंड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ सपोर्ट इज दिस बेसिकली? सो द स्टार्टअप्स आर प्रोवाइडेड विद द फाइनेंशियल सपोर्ट, विद द टेक्निकल सपोर्ट, विद द इंक्यूबेटर सपोर्ट, विद द एक्सेलरेटर सपोर्ट. एवरी काइंड ऑफ सपोर्ट विच अ स्टार्टअप इज रिक्वायर्ड इज प्रोवाइडेड अंडर निर्माण एक्सेलरेटर प्रोग्राम. So the objective is to enable comprehensive nurturing and fostering of the startups through effective mentoring and market access, right? Mentoring in development of the product and then helping the startups in selling their products. ठीक है? It was launched this year only 2022 by Startups Incubation and Innovation Center of IIT Kanpur. So it is a project of Incubation Center of IIT Kanpur, right? But it is supported by Department of Science and Technology. Ministry which works, of course, which is under the Ministry of Science and Technology through a scheme which is known as what? Nidhi scheme, right? Nidhi scheme ki bhi baat karenge, don't worry. Now it provides support to solve challenges in the product development journey of indigenous innovation, right? Especially in the area of agriculture and health, right? The major focus is on agriculture and health, right? Innovation in the area of agriculture and health. Now talking about Nidhi, so what is Nidhi? It is National Initiative for Developing and Harnessing Innovation. That is the full form. Now as the full form says, it is National Initiative for Developing and Harnessing Innovation, which means some kind of support is being provided under this scheme for innovation, right? And it is an umbrella program. It is an umbrella program of Ministry of Science and Technology, right? जो कि startups को support provide कराता है. And there are various initiatives like Nirman Accelerator Program under this umbrella program to provide support to the startups, right? Now it aims to nurture startups through scouting, supporting and scaling of innovation and funding to the Nidhi program. To the Nidhi initiative is provided by National Science and Technology Entrepreneurship Development Board, which works under the Ministry of Science and Technology only. All right, I hope this news is clear. And the question was, which institute had launched this program? So it is a program of incubator support of IIT Kanpur. Option C is the correct answer. I hope this question is clear. Let's talk about question number 2 then. Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, that is the full name of the ministry, which is headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal, has revamped the National Consumer Helpline to provide services in how many languages? So earlier the National Consumer Helpline was available in 2 languages only, but to expand its services, now it has been revamped and now the services will be available. From now, the services will be available in 12 languages. So the answer to this question is 12, right? But there is one more thing which has been launched, which is Right to Repair portal, right? Right to Repair portal. Now, what is Right to Repair? See, what happens is that, let's say I bought this screen, right? And let's say tomorrow or after 6 months or 1 year, there is a problem, there is a technical issue in it. राइट, कोई टेक्निकल, कोई सॉफ्टवेयर प्रॉब्लम है या कोई हार्डवेयर प्रॉब्लम है. सो द मैन्युफैक्चरर विल हैव टू प्रोवाइड मी विद द सर्टेन इक्विपमेंट्स सो दैट आई कैन माई सेल्फ रिपेयर दिस प्रोडक्ट, और I can repair this product with the help of a third party agency and I should not depend on the original manufacturer for its repairing. This is what we called as right to repair. And for that, a portal has been launched. And what will happen in this portal? So manufacturers will share the manual of product details. Okay, whatever the product the manufacturer is selling, he or she will share the manual of product details with customers so that they could either repair by self, by third parties, rather than depending on the original manufacturer. Alright. And initially, mobile phones, electronics, consumer durables, automobiles, and farming equipments are considered under this right to repair. Right, and the second news, jo maine aapko bata diya, the National Consumer Helpline, it has been revamped to launch, it has been revamped, in fact, to provide services in 12 languages. And earlier, it was available in 2 languages only. Theek hai? And therefore, the correct answer is what? I already told you this. Option D, 12 is the correct answer. Let's talk about question number 3 then. President Draupadi Murmu has recently inaugurated the project development of Sri Sailam Temple in the state of Andhra Pradesh at Kurnool under Prashad scheme. Identify incorrect statement about Prashad scheme. What is the full form of Prashad? By the way, it is pilgrimage, rejuvenation and spiritual heritage augmentation drive. Right, let me write it here. Heritage augmentation drive. This is the full form of Prashad. I hope you know the full form. Agar nahi pata hai to koi baat nahi, yahan se dekh lo. Pilgrimage, rejuvenation and spiritual heritage augmentation drive is the full form of Prashad. It is a scheme. Right, so first of all, chalo ye kyun hai news mein, wo to question se hi clear ho gaya, because a project under this scheme, which is development of Sri Sailam Temple at Kurnool, Andhra Pradesh, has been launched by President Draupadi Murmu. Right, this project has been sanctioned and executed under Prashad scheme and it was 100% funded by Ministry of Tourism. Now, talking about Prashad scheme, so as the name suggests, what is the full form? Pilgrimage, Rejuvenation and Spiritual Heritage Augmentation Drive, which means the government is developing, the government is rejuvenating the pilgrimage areas, the pilgrimage, the sacred regions of the country. So, development and promotion of religious tourism in the country to integrate pilgrimage destinations in a prioritized, planned and sustainable manner to provide a complete religious tourism experience. So, basically to promote the religious tourism, the scheme is being implemented by Ministry of Tourism since 2014. 2014 mein isko launch kiya gaya tha, right, by Ministry of Tourism. And financing, it is a central sector scheme, which means it is 100% funded by the central government. There is no share of state in it. And it focuses on integrating infrastructure development. Infrastructure development kya ho sakta hai? Like parking areas, like toilet facilities. Theek hai? Is tarike ki facilities are being developed in these areas so that the tourism, the religious tourism could be promoted. Theek hai? And of course, it will create the employment opportunities as well. Theek hai ji? So, let's identify the incorrect statement about this scheme. It was launched in 2014, sahi baat hai. It stands for Pilgrimage, Rejuvenation and Spiritual Heritage Augmentation Drive. Absolutely correct. It is a central sector scheme. 100% correct. It is being implemented by Ministry of Culture. No, it is not being implemented by Ministry of Culture. It is being implemented by which ministry? Ministry of Tourism, headed by G. Kishan Reddy. G.K. Reddy is the minister, right? So, option D, guys, will be the correct answer. Question number 4 pe aa jate hain. Consider the following statements with respect to Vishwas Yojana and you have to identify the correct statement. Vishwas Yojana is being implemented by Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, right? And it is again not a new scheme. It is in news because iske respect mein koi statement release hui thi parliament mein. Isiliye we are discussing about it, alright? So let's talk about Vishwas Yojana and then we will come back to the question. So basically Vishwas Yojana is for providing financial assistance to SC and OBC self-help groups and individuals as well in the form of interest subvention. Now for what this financial assistance is provided? For starting up their own enterprises. Apna agar wo koi enterprise shuru karte hain to uske liye इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन के फॉर्म में फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंस प्रोवाइड कराया जाता है टू एससी एंड ओबीसी. सो रिमेंबर देर आर ओनली टू कैटेगरीज इन इट, प्लीज डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज. देर आर टू कैटेगरीज विच आर एससी एंड ओबीसी, ठीक है. एंड अमंग दैट एससी एंड ओबीसी सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप्स को भी मिलेगा एंड इंडिविजुअल्स को भी मिलेगा, राइट. इट वॉज लॉन्च 2 years back 2020 बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ सोशल जस्टिस एंड एम्पावरमेंट. एंड द इम्प्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी आर नेशनल शेड्यूल कास्ट फाइनेंस डेवलपमेंट कॉर्पोरेशन एंड नेशनल बैकवर्ड क्लास फाइनेंस एंड डेवलपमेंट कॉर्पोरेशन, राइट. दीज टू एंटिटीज वर्क अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ सोशल जस्टिस एंड एम्पावरमेंट ओनली. ऑलराइट, नाउ टॉकिंग मोर अबाउट दिस स्कीम. सो हु आर द एलिजिबल बेनिफिशियरीज. सो देर इज ओनली वन eligibility criteria, that is the family income of that beneficiary should not exceed rupees 3 lakh, right. But this is only with the case of individuals, because SHG ke case mein ye wala criteria applicable nahi ho payega. Now interest subvention, so as I told you that the financial assistance is provided in the form of interest subvention. So how much interest subvention is this? So for both SHG and individuals, 5% interest subvention is provided. But there is a difference. For SHG, this interest subvention is provided for a loan up to rupees 4 lakhs. Right? But in case of individuals, this loan limit is rupees, how much? Up to rupees 2 lakhs. Alright? So that is the difference between SHG and individual. Alright? So that is all about this scheme. And let's identify the correct statement. It is being implemented by Ministry of Education. No. It is Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment headed by Dr. Virendra Kumar. The beneficiary should have family income up to rupees 3 lakh. Bilkul sahi baat hai. There is no issue in it. And in case of SHG beneficiary, 5% interest subvention is provided for loans up to rupees 4 lakh. Yes, in case of SHG, it is up to 4 lakh. While in case of individuals, it is rupees 2 lakhs. Alright. So 2 and 3 should be the correct answer. Option B. Because we have to identify the correct statement. All right. Yes, and there is a full form of Vishwas as well. What is the full form? Vishwas stands for Vanchit. Vanchit Ikai Samuh. Vanchit Ikai Samuh. Or Vargon Ki Arthik Sahayata. Arthik Sahayata. Arthik Sahayata means financial help. And Vanchit Ikai Samuh means those groups which are underserved and unserved. So here in this case, these are SC and OBC. Okay? Let's talk about question number 5. Consider the following statement with respect to Nasha Mukt Bharat Abhiyan, and you have to identify the incorrect statement. So it is not a new Abhiyan. It was launched, I believe last year it was launched in the year 2021. But it is in news because the government has announced that this Nasha Mukt Bharat Abhiyan will take place in 17,000 border villages. 17,000 border villages in the month of May 2023, and that is why it is in news. ठीक है, तो इसके बारे में बात कर लेते हैं. तो नशा मुक्त भारत अभियान, of course, as the name says, it is an abhiyan to create an awareness among the young generation to stay away from the substance use, right? So to reach out to the masses and spread awareness about substance use, and not 2021, it was launched in 2020 by Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, and it is currently being implemented in 372 districts of the country, which are the most vulnerable districts. And the identification of these districts was based on the findings of very first comprehensive national survey and inputs provided by the National Narcotics Bureau. ठीक है, नारकोटिक्स ब्यूरो ने जो भी इनपुट्स दिए थे उसके बेसिस पे दीस 372 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स हैव बीन आइडेंटिफाइड एंड दिस प्रोग्राम इज बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड देयर. ठीक है, नाउ द स्पेशल फोकस ऑफ दिस प्रोग्राम इज ऑन हायर एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस, बिकॉज़ दैट इज दी वो ये यहां के जो बच्चे होते हैं हायर एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस के, दीज आर मोर वल्नरेबल, दीज आर द मोस्ट वल्नरेबल सेक्शंस टू दीज सब्सटेंस अब्यूज. ठीक है, university campuses and schools, reaching out and identifying dependent population, right, rehabilitation center, capacity building programs. And as I told you, this abhiyan will be implemented in 17,000 border villages across 18 states and UTs in the month of May 2023. theek hai, to ab aa jate hain fir se question pe. It was launched in 2021. No, 2020 में लॉन्च हुआ था. इट इज बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड इन 272 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स. इज दैट सो? नो, 372 में. एंड ड्यूरिंग मे 2023 दिस अभियान विल बी इंप्लीमेंटेड इन 17,000 बॉर्डर विलेजेस इन 18 स्टेट्स और यूटीज. सो थर्ड स्टेटमेंट इज करेक्ट. बट रिमेंबर वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट विच मीन्स ऑप्शन ए. ओनली 1 and 2 विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 पे आ जाते हैं. बट बिफोर दैट, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू हैव द PDF ऑफ दिस सेशन, यू कैन ज्वाइन दिस टेलीग्राम चैनल. द लिंक इज प्रोवाइडेड इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन. ठीक है. एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू आस्क एनीथिंग रिलेटेड टू एग्जामिनेशन, यू कैन फॉलो मी हियर. एंड येस, दीज फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन नंबर 6, द क्वेश्चन आर सच विच डू नॉट रिक्वायर मच एक्सप्लेनेशन. क्वेश्चन के अंदर ही सारा इंफॉर्मेशन ऑलरेडी होता है. ठीक है. तो क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 की बात करें अगर हम, सो फ्रॉम व्हेन मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ सोशल जस्टिस एंड एम्पावरमेंट हैज अनाउंस्ड टू वेव ऑफ द रजिस्ट्रेशन और डायग्नोस्टिक और ट्रीटमेंट फी एट ऑल नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट्स और कंपोजिट रीजनल सेंटर्स अंडर द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एम्पावरमेंट ऑफ पर्सन फॉर दिव्यांगजन हैविंग यूनिक ID फॉर पर्सन विद डिसेबिलिटी कार्ड्स. तो दोज पर्सन हु पजेस दीज कार्ड्स, यूनिक ID फॉर पर्सन विद डिसेबिलिटीज, दे विल be provided with absolutely free treatment, with absolutely free diagnostics, with absolutely free registration at the national institutes or the composite regional centers under the Department of Empowerment of Person with Disabilities, right? So from when it will be, you know, ye kab se implement ho jayega, from when it will be implemented? So it will be from 1st of January 2023. Option A is the correct answer. Question number 7, which government organization has been awarded the Data Security Council of India Annual Information Security Summit DSCI AISSS Award for Best Security Practices in Government Sector? तो कौन से organization को दिया गया है ये award? So it is once again UIDAI, Unique Identification Authority of India, whose headquarters has been awarded with the Grah Award also. ठीक है, ये हमने एक दो दिन पहले ही पढ़ा था. Question number 8, the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved the MSP for fair average quality of milling copra at ₹10,860 per quintal and for boiled copra at this. So we are talking about copra. So let's jump to the last line where the actual question is. The actual question is, which of the following act as the central nodal agency for procurement of copra? This can be asked in your NABARD examination. It is important for NABARD. ठीक है. However, कभी कहीं पे भी पूछ सकते हैं. इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी कि NABARD में ही आएगा. सो देर आर टू एजेंसीज, देर आर टू नोडल एजेंसीज इन द कंट्री फॉर प्रोक्योरमेंट ऑफ कोपरा एंड दीज आर नेशनल एग्रीकल्चर कोऑपरेटिव मार्केटिंग फेडरेशन लिमिटेड एंड नेशनल कोऑपरेटिव कंज्यूमर फेडरेशन. ठीक है. तो ए एंड बी, ऑप्शन डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 9, विच PSU हैज वन द बेस्ट ग्लोबली कॉम्पिटेटिव पावर कंपनी ऑफ इंडिया हाइड्रो पावर एंड रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी सेक्टर एट प्रकाश में 15th इनर्शिया अवार्ड्स ऑफ 2022. नाउ इन सच न्यूज ऑफ कोर्स यू डोंट हैव टू गो इनटू द डिटेल्स. यू नो द नेम ऑफ PSU, यू नो द नेम ऑफ कैटेगरी ऑफ अवार्ड्स, दैट्स इट, इनफ. एंड यस, इट इज NHPC लिमिटेड. ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. द 46th मीटिंग ऑफ द एग्जीक्यूटिव कमिटी ऑफ नेशनल कमीशन फॉर क्लीन गंगा वॉज रिसेंटली ऑर्गेनाइज अंडर द चेयरपर्सनशिप of DGNMCG. It approved afforestation programs for the year 2022-2023 for which states? Right? It is an important question, guys. So for Uttarakhand and Bihar, the programs have been approved. Option B, 1 and 3 is the correct answer. Okay? The next question is also based on this 46th meeting of Executive Committee of NMCG. In this, they have launched a project titled Scientific exploration of floral diversity near the Ganga River banks for ethnobotanical purposes, along with their conservation and economic development of the region via skill development program. Okay? The question is, the project has three components. So which of the following are the three components under this project? Now, of course, you don't have to go into the details of this project. There is no need. Just remember, it has been launched by NMCG with three components, which are plant diversity, biodiversity exploration, training and skill development, and advanced scientific research and experimentation. So 1, 2 and 3, option A will be the correct answer. And the last question for today, very easy question, where was Bijli Utsav, Electricity Festival or Mahotsav, organized by REC Limited, which is a Maharatna company under Ministry of Power, as part of Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, which is of course to celebrate 75 years of independence. So it took place in Vadodara, which is in Gujarat. Option C is the correct answer. Alright guys, so that's it for today's session. I hope all the questions are clear and the explanations are clear. I wish you a very happy new year in advance. And jo bhi aapke wishes hain, I hope wo puri ho 2023 mein. Jo galtiyan aapne ki hain, usko dobara repeat nahi karna hai. And jo aap seekhne se reh gaye hain, usko aapko seekhna hai in the next year. Alright? So all the very best for the upcoming year and for the upcoming examination. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care and God bless.